I would like to introduce myself briefly. I'm in my daily life as a researcher, I'm involved in this cross-border research collaboration between the University of Copenhagen, where I'm located, and the University of Lund, just across the strait in Sweden, where we focus on understanding decay of outdoor exposed wood in order to be able to make better durable wood products without toxic biocides. But what I'm here to talk about today is an effort I was involved in where we tried to disseminate the benefits of using wood products in construction to the Danish broader general public. So, to give you some background, most of you here probably know that there's a wood revolution underway, because in the construction sector, replacing carbon-heavy construction materials with wood has huge benefits in reducing the carbon footprint of the building industry. So currently, in the Western world, in Europe and North America, we see that more and more timber buildings are erected. Here, this is from this is the largest building made with wood in Norway currently, Mjøstårnet. And but not in Denmark, at least not up until last year, because even though the media is full, as always, of reports on societal problems like climate change, carbon footprint, excessive consumption, etc., etc., wood and forestry are rarely seen or reported as part of the solution. And even wood used for construction is ridiculed. For instance, like last year in a radio program on the Danish radio, a professor in building science from Aalborg University were discussing the carbon footprint of the construction sector, and especially of the use of concrete, and was asked by the reporter, what alternative materials do we have to concrete? And the answer was, and I tried to translate it as literally as possible, was, well, we have steel, and in a modest extent, and not worth mentioning, we can also build a pedestrian bridge out of some wood. There you have it. So, no alternatives, really. Okay, but I'm involved in this Danish network for tall-rise wood buildings that is also now expanded to be a Nordic network, where there are several working groups. And one of the working groups that I'm involved in is called Sustainability, where we have partners from academia, industry associations, architect engineers. And at our first meeting in February last year, well, the conclusion was somebody should do something to communicate the benefits of using wood for construction. Somebody. And I don't know about you, but sometimes in life you find that that somebody is you, because nobody else is there to do it. So, we had to do something. So over the course of two months, from November 18 until the beginning of this year, we had, well, I write 10 media appearances, and there's been more later, but that was the really intense period where we, with opinion pieces about once per week, we had a new piece in the news, in different online and printed media, where we talk about the benefits of using wood for construction. And did that have any effect? Well, first of all, let's see, what did we actually do? We tried to focus on the simple facts, to really communicate that to the broad, to the general public. And those simple facts were, forest takes up CO2 and stores the carbon in wood. Wood from sustainable forestry is a renewable material. Wood is light but strong. Timber buildings have a reduced carbon footprint, and timber buildings use less sand, gravel and cement, but unfortunately Denmark is falling behind the rest of Europe when it comes to building with wood. Those are the simple facts that we focused on. And what effects might it have had? Well, we see today, I'm not saying that this was directly an effect of it, but we see today that there's a lot more media attention, positive media attention, on using wood for construction. This is an outtake of various pieces from the media. We might not have had this direct effect, but we can at least see that some of these pieces are using the same argumentations, the same structure, the same facts that we have been promoting in some of these pieces that we've written. And I should mention this on the right. This is a magazine from one of the largest Danish supermarkets. I guess it's one of the most widely read magazines in Denmark, going out to nearly everyone, where they have a theme in September, where the main story was that you can make almost everything out of wood. Other effects? Well, more voices have joined the public debate now. Other people from across the industry are now voicing their opinion on using more wood for the construction industry. And now we have a government and a parliament who wants to build more with wood, or at least to give wood construction equal footing with traditional concrete construction. So seeing if there's anything legislatively they can do to facilitate that wood becomes an equal option compared with concrete. That's good. So after this intense period, I tried to reflect, what did we actually do right? I'm not saying that all of this was effects of what we did, but some of it might have pushed it. And what we did right, I think, was that we used positive language as far as possible. Like, we need to talk wood up, don't talk other materials down, although it is difficult to say that timber construction can reduce the carbon footprint compared to conventional buildings, let's call it that. But we need to talk about concrete a little bit. But we also use balanced arguments, I think, as far as possible, because wood cannot save the world. It's part of the solution together with forestry. But there's, of course, other things we need to do. We cannot avoid using some concrete. So it's good to have less, more sustainable concrete, of course. And then repeat the facts and be consistent. So this is the same facts, it's a new story. It's a trick I learned from some of the politicians. Be relevant, so looking for hooks for these pieces in the news, in the public debate. There was a report about how the Danish capital region will run out of sand for the construction industry within the next decade. That's a good hook for telling that you don't need to use so much sand if you save some of the concrete with wood. And I think most importantly, this group that I was involved in, this working group, we had this broad and deep professional knowledge from the entire value chain, from forest to buildings, because we involved so many participants from across the value chain. Has there been any opposition? Well, a little bit. This was from September this year. Concrete researchers yelling, fire! You know, 200 years ago or more, we had some really detrimental fires in Copenhagen. And do you remember Dresden in 45? Yeah, I think some of us do. And that was, of course, horrible. But of course, it was also a nice occasion to say, well, I think we've done something to make it more fireproof since 200 years ago. Something has improved in the way we build with wood today. So the general opinion now in the Danish building sector can be summed as, well, it's not about building either with concrete or wood, but about using both. And that's exactly also what we have stated repeatedly. So using more wood, but we cannot completely avoid concrete. So looking at this agenda, I was supposed to say also something about this. Maybe this statement on page 37, that wood has a bright future, maybe it will even be true, come true in a little country like Denmark. So I just briefly want to talk about this one, the research agenda, because climate change is coming. And of course, building with wood over here is part of the solution. We can reduce our climate impact, but still it's a major challenge in our forests and how we manage the forests, what species we are going to plant. And this is where the resources come for building with wood. And right now, Right now, there's supposed to be some exchange going on here in terms of knowledge, but I'm not necessarily sure that it's happening. So I'm questioning whether we have the right discussions going across the value chain so we can have a stronger cross-sectional collaboration.